This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes some of the key cost terms associated with differential analysis. I've got several videos that have been posted on YouTube related to differential analysis, so this is a summary of the terms. If you want to look at how to perform differential analysis, you'll need to take a look at some of the other videos. The key terms here, what do we mean by differential analysis, or what's often called incremental analysis? What that means is we're going to take a look at the revenues and costs associated with each alternative that we are considering. So for example, we might be considering a product line decision where we are a computer company and we manufacture desktop computers, laptop computers, and tablets. And perhaps our desktop computers are ending or are coming close to the end of their life cycle, and maybe they're not profitable for us. So we're considering dropping the desktop computers and the production of those computers. Well, the way to analyze that then using differential analysis is to take a look at the revenues. We call these differential revenues and costs. Take a look at the revenues that we would have with the desktop computer along with our other product lines and without the desktop computer product line. And we do the same with costs. So we would assess the revenues and the costs that differ from one alternative to another, and then take a look at the bottom line in terms of profit and see which alternative yields the highest profit. There's another term on this slide called avoidable costs, and those are the costs that can be avoided by selecting a particular course of action, and so therefore avoidable costs are treated as differential costs. So as an example, if we are trying to figure out whether to drop our desktop computer product line, it may be that if we do drop that product line, we are able to eliminate costs related to the direct materials that go into making those computers. So those would be considered avoidable costs, and those would be part of our differential analysis. There are four more terms to take a look at as outlined on this slide. We'll start with opportunity costs. So these are the costs of the benefits foregone when one alternative is selected over another, and they're treated as differential costs. And I like to say these are what we give up to get something else. As an example, if we are, I'll continue with my product line example, if we're considering eliminating our desktop computer product line, it might be that we can use the space that we currently use to produce those computers to expand other product lines. And there are benefits then from expanding those other product lines. And we'd have to consider that then in our analysis. And those would be part of our differential analysis. The second term you see here is related to what we call sunk costs. These are costs that are incurred in the past that cannot be changed by future decisions. As an example, to continue our example of trying to figure out whether to drop our desktop computers, perhaps we bought some machinery several years ago and paid for it that relates to the production of those desktop computers, and it was a significant expenditure. And we hate to drop that product line because we've got this machinery that we purchased in the past. Well, the reality is that's a sunk cost. There's nothing we can do about that, and we should not consider those costs in our differential analysis. Next, we have direct fixed costs. And those are the fixed costs that can be traced directly to a product line, for example, or a customer, and they should be treated as differential costs. So these would be costs that if we were to eliminate, in our example, the desktop computers, these are fixed costs that would go away as a result of eliminating those desktop computers. Maybe we have, for example, a person that is in charge of sales for that product line, and we would no longer need that employee, and therefore that cost would be reduced. That is a differential cost. We also are looking at the last term here, allocated fixed costs, and these are the fixed costs that the company incurs but are not traced directly to a particular product line or to a particular customer. That is, these costs do not go away if we decide to eliminate, for example, our desktop computer product line. These are called allocated fixed costs, and they simply get reallocated to the remaining product lines, but in total, they do not change. So these are all the important cost terms that you should be familiar with when you are looking at performing differential analysis.